We opened with Kirkpatrick Fanfare, and if you notice, there were two melodies you heard. You heard this little melody in the flute that sounds like this in the very beginning. You also heard at the end maybe Danny Boy. You recognize Danny Boy, Love Derriere. If you're not sure, it sounds like this. And the cool thing about this piece is, and I want to explain it a little bit, is that have you ever seen the movie The Sixth Sense? This movie is kind of like The Sixth Sense. I'll show you what I mean. Pretty much everything is based off one of those melodies here. Let me give you an example. You heard at one point the clarinets do this. If I go note by note, it's just da-da-da-dee-da-da-da-da-da. It is Danny Boy. You heard the mallets do this at one point. Da-da-da-dee-da-da-da-da-dum-ding-da-dum-da-dum-dum. It's Danny Boy. Yeah, you hear all the woodwinds do this at one point. That's just this thing over and over again. Da-da-da-dee-da-dee-dum. But here's where it gets like the Sixth Sense. Play your melody again. I play it slowly. Now really slow. Now slowly with a different rhythm, but same notes. It's Danny Boy. he was dead the whole movie. I get shivers thinking about it. At the end, we hear that, all of a sudden, it's Danny Boy. It's like, oh, he actually wasn't touching that. He wasn't actually talking to her. She wasn't in the room. Anyway, that's perfect. We continue with a piece by Julie Giraud, who has her roots in film music, worked with great composers like Bill Conti, who wrote Rocky, John Williams, who you know what he wrote. And so she has a real ear for film music. This is essentially a film without a film. It's film music without an actual film. It's called Shine. Takes place in the 20s, during Prohibition, and all the stuff that happens there. I won't explain any more than that, because I think the colors and scope and narrative the piece will take care of itself. This is Julie Giraud's Shine.
Thank you.
Jody Blanchard is an Australian composer who wrote piece names are based on a book of the same title. Mostly what you need to know about this is that it's kind of her call for humility, peace, for coming together, for striving past our differences, for finding some sort of common ground, both inner peace and outer peace. If you know any of her music, this is exactly the kind of thing that she's huge advocate for. I was actually emailing her maybe 2 weeks ago, and she lives in Australia, and she actually had to evacuate her home outside of Sydney because of the bushfires that are coming through. So it's quite, imagine how unnerving it is to be emailing someone who said, well, I have to actually leave my house now because there's a fire about a kilometer away. Puts this piece into a new perspective. It's one long movement, but there are four little movements, and I want to make sure I don't mess up the order of them. You'll hear meditation, awakening, realization, and humility. And I think you just remember those. Meditation, this very, very ethereal opening. Awakening, when things start to blossom a little bit. Realization, when there's this, think of a musical light bulb, where all of a sudden, I figured it out. And then humility at the end, when you kind of take stock of what you just figured out, and try to keep in perspective, and I think you'll hear that at the end of this. This is Jody Blatchell's Peace Dancer. you're here for more than one concert, you're probably going to hear like 8 versions of what I'm going to say right now. But I have to say it, because honor band conductors often feel, or at least I do, like a little bit like a fraud. Because I've known these students for 2.5 days, and the way they sound has nothing to do with me at all. If there are band directors in the audience, are you here? Can you stand up and let us acknowledge the folks in the room? So we're putting the concert together, all these bands are putting the concert together in 2.5 days, which is really a credit to their teachers and credit to them. They come in, they read the music for the first time on Friday, and then they came from the minute they got here, they were focused. And even when they were tired after playing for 3 hours, hearing 3 hours of fantastic concerts, playing for another couple of hours, going to bed late, getting here early, they were still focused this morning and ready to keep making improvement. And so I thank you for that. A joy to be a part of. I've got to thank Dr. CJT, or she doesn't care what she's called, Dr. Turner, for inviting me, and is Professor Akridge here? Rob Akridge? He's backstage, who's the mastermind behind all this, and the person that we never met until we got here, but we exchanged like 17,000 emails with him, and so we thank him. Our next piece, Wapango. Anyone know this piece? Cool, you can dance here or there, and if you don't know it, you can eventually dance. The challenge with this piece for us is that it's simultaneously in 2 meters as most music or a lot of dance music from Mexico and that area are. So in other words, if you're not sure what I mean, sometimes it feels like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, sometimes it feels like 1, 2, 3. Or if you know West Side Story, I want to be in America, okay to be in America. That's what this piece is at the same time. I want you to experience what they experience, so you do it with us. All right, try it with me, ready? I'm gonna go, so it's 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, ready? And. Towards the end to do it with us as the grand finale. This is Jose Pablo Montayo's Wapango. We haven't played it yet, so. Thank you.
Thank you.